You're listening to the audio production of More Than a Mom, How Prioritizing Your Wellness Helps You and Your Family Thrive, by Kari Kampakis, published by Thomas Nelson and read by the author. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harperchristianaudio.com.
To my sisters in motherhood, I pray this book encourages you and reminds you that you are loved, needed, and worthy of care and attention. Introduction. Don't confuse invisibility with insignificance. Christine Kane. The day I became a mom was the best day of my life. I had no idea what a game changer meeting my baby would be. I was physically exhausted from labor, yet mentally elated. Who knew that my heart could swell with such unconditional, unreciprocated, one-way love? I knew that my daughter would never love me the way I loved her, yet that was the beauty of our situation. After a lifetime of selfishness, I was ready to be the giver, and I was determined to do it well. Then and there, my life split into two, before and after. If ever I had questioned my existence or wondered what good I added to this world, I finally had an answer. God had chosen me to raise this remarkable child, and she inspired in me a sense of purpose unlike anything I had known before. In many ways, motherhood was a dream, even with the sleep deprivation and worry. I saw the world through new eyes, the eyes of a protective mom. I marveled over the love for my child that felt simultaneously tender and fierce. Days turned into weeks, weeks turned into years, and years turned into seasons as my baby grew up and welcomed three siblings. Each new child evoked a new rush of elation and extra determination to do motherhood well. I can't pinpoint when motherhood started to feel hard because every stage has brought trials and challenges. What I can say now, 20 years into this journey, is that it has surpassed my greatest expectations and dashed some expectations too. Motherhood has brought countless moments of joy, laughter, transformation, meaning, gratitude, and euphoria. It has convinced me that there is indeed a heaven and a God who created us and loves us all. But on the hard days, there are struggles behind the scenes, struggles that we talk about only with our closest friends because we need someone who understands. I'm talking about those moments when we feel overwhelmed, spent, anxious, lonely, guilty, unappreciated, ashamed, angry, reactive, scared, discouraged, frustrated, or sad. When we are hurt by the lack of gratitude or support from our family and exhausted by our invisible load. When we give our absolute best, yet we see no progress or rewards. When we wonder where we went wrong or if we've gotten it all wrong. When the constant influx of needs and demands keeps us living in survival mode. When we try to be strong for everyone, yet inside, we just want to scream. And it is that dichotomy, where we look strong and capable externally, yet feel mounting tension internally, that drives a mom to her breaking point. Even mothers who hit all the marks may not be well or on a good path. For this reason, we need to talk about a mom's inner life. We need safe places to process our struggles and needs, friends who listen and empathize, and healthy conversations that move us forward so we can genuinely thrive. My friend, this book is designed to serve that purpose. I hope to be the friend to you that my friends have been to me. I may not know your journey, whether you have one child or seven, boys or girls, toddlers or teenagers, babies you birthed or children you adopted, but I can assume this. You love your family passionately, yet the same love that drives you can also deplete you because it never feels like enough. With motherhood, there is no stopping point. There is no clocking out, checking out, or leaving work behind. As your kids grow up, the demands on you multiply. Boundaries blur, life gets real, and you get stretched too thin. Mothers sacrifice. It is what we do best. Yet sometimes in our determination to love our people well, we overextend ourselves. We get lost in our support roles, tending to everyone else's needs while forgetting about our own. We prioritize the wellness of our loved ones at the expense of our wellness. We let sacrifices evolve into quiet self-neglect. We take our sick children to the doctor, yet push through our illnesses. We bathe our baby every day, yet skip our own shower. We enforce our toddler's bedtime, yet stay up until 2 a.m. to finish our work. We sign up our 5-year-old for soccer and tennis, yet don't consider a personal hobby. We make our kids sit down and eat whole meals, yet eat protein bars on the run. We seek therapy for our struggling teen, yet wrestle with our problems alone. We give our family a soft place to land, yet shoulder the burden of everyone's pain, even if it crushes us to keep a happy, peaceful home. In short, we dismiss our own needs to serve as givers. We carry on long after our minds, bodies, and spirits tell us to rest or quit. We forget that we are, first and foremost, human beings. We hold unrealistic expectations of what it means to be human. We wonder why we hit brick walls, see the wheels fall off, and beg someone to throw us a bone because we are exhausted. In your journey as a giver, you work overtime. You try hard to be the best mom, person, and role model you can be. You're scared to fail because the stakes are high, yet even on good days, you may feel like you're failing someone. You have a critic in your head who picks you and your choices apart. What if I told you, 1, you're doing better than you think, 2, your kids aren't critiquing you the way you critique yourself, 3, you have value and purpose beyond your role as a mom, and 4, to serve your family well, you must tend to your needs and wellness too. After all, you can only take your children as far as you have come. Raising healthy kids begins with them seeing a healthy mom. If you're not in a healthy place or working to get there, then failure on your part is more likely. You'll struggle to find the strength, stamina, patience, and presence you need to be a healthy giver. In their book, The Power of Showing Up, New York Times bestselling authors Dr. Daniel Siegel and Dr. Tina Payne Bryson say children need 4 things for healthy development. They need to feel safe, seen, soothed, and secure. Parents who show up and offer a quality of presence help their children thrive. Dr. Bryson says, one of the very best scientific predictors for how any child turns out in terms of happiness, social skills, mental health, academic success, and meaningful relationships is whether at least one adult in their life has consistently shown up for them. These findings, based on brain and attachment research, remind us of how important it is to simply engage with our children, pay attention to their lives, and be emotionally stable and available. Motherhood motivates, and knowing that your health directly impacts your children is a powerful incentive. With that in mind, I wrote this book. It's your guide to inner wellness and includes 10 ways to grow stronger from the inside out through 10 life habits you can incorporate to become the mother, woman, and role model you are meant to be. The best part is you don't have to be perfect. Why? Because perfect parents don't prepare their children for an imperfect world. Perfect parents don't admit their need for Jesus or acknowledge their own struggles. The older your children get, the more you parent with influence rather than power. Instead of seeing your trials as defeats, see the opportunities. When you respond in healthy ways, you prepare your children for their trials. You give them a model to draw on during their own dark days. This reference point matters because your children mostly see perfection, perceived, not real. They scroll through social media and think something must be wrong with them since everyone else is living the dream. Even well-meaning parents can feed this illusion. And I often think about the 17-year-old girl who cried to her parents during a heart-to-heart talk as she finally admitted, "You two are just so perfect, and I feel like I can never measure up." Her parents were heartbroken because they never intended to portray that image. Yet sometimes, in our effort to be good role models, we hide our humanity. While we certainly shouldn't burden our children with problems best taken to other adults, it does help them to see us cope with some problems in positive, productive ways. None of us imagined, as we cradled newborn babies, that one day we'd have to parent while also handling major league stress. We didn't realize how much strength and resilience we'd need to handle the heartaches life can bring. Your journey as a mother may get lonely, but you are never alone. You always have Jesus and the Holy Spirit, God's presence in the heart of believers, to strengthen, empower, and guide you. In John 16:33, Jesus says, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." Without Jesus, you are powerless, but with Him, you grow equipped. You have God's mighty power on your side. As moms, we often need permission to take better care of ourselves. We long to reach our full potential without vanity, guilt, or obsession. Your greatest life purpose, even greater than motherhood, is to know, love, and serve God. As you journey toward genuine wellness, you also journey toward Him. You become a light for those who know you. Wellness helps you become the best version of yourself so you can bravely and boldly serve God. It makes you a good steward of the gifts He has given you, such as your family, your body, your soul, and your time. Even exceptional givers have legitimate needs as humans, and as you read on, I pray you feel loved by the ultimate giver, who sacrificed His only Son for you and restores you when you grow weary. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. James 1:17. Inspire your kids to outdo you. A panel of moms raising teenagers spoke to young moms. Their main takeaway was this: don't run yourself so hard during the day that you have nothing left to give when your kids come home from school. Wow, this speaks to me. Too often, the reason why I feel depleted is because I've worked myself to my limits. It only takes one rude comment from a child or one email with an urgent deadline to push me over the edge. The good news is, I know myself. I'm aware of what works and doesn't work in my life. I also know, as the mom of three teenagers and one preteen, that older kids have keen observational skills. My children will always remember what they witness in my life right now, and as I prepare them for the real world, I focus on two things: their health and their relationship with God. Ultimately, these things matter most, and if they get them right, their lives will fall into order. This is equally true for you. You may be quick to sacrifice, but don't sacrifice your wellness. Don't forget the hidden benefits of modeling a healthy adult lifestyle. By doing this well, you give your children a head start. You equip them to outdo you. And isn't that the goal of parenting? Don't we all want our kids to outdo us, to live lives that are longer, smarter, and more fruitful than the lives we have lived? My dad once counseled a college boy who got upset over his little brother's athletic talent. Beginning in middle school, this little brother exceeded his big brother's records. My father told the elder son, "You better hope your little brother does better than you, because that means you did your job." In short, it is our job to turn around and empower those behind us. We are called to help them, inspire them, and set a good example. Your life gains purpose as you allow the next generation to learn from your mistakes and build on what you started. Let them see a picture of wellness and watch them carry that knowledge with them as they get launched into the future. Like arrows in the hands of a warrior are children born in one's youth. Psalm 127:4. Join this journey. This book will release just before my 50th birthday. At this point, I'm reflecting on the past, dreaming about the future, and aiming to stay healthy and strong for the second half of my life. Rarely does a mother's strength look like the cover of a fitness magazine. More often, it plays out in subtle ways. It may look like showing your vulnerable side, admitting you need help, begging God to heal your child, holding it together as you watch your child suffer, insisting on answers to a mystery illness, attending a party alone, mustering the courage to make new friends, starting over, moving back in with your parents, finding a job, advocating for your child, watching your son choose his wife and get married, letting your daughter pull away and become independent, ending a toxic relationship, standing alone in a decision, parenting a disagreeable teenager, selling prized possessions to afford professional help for your child, being kind to an unkind person, parenting a child who requires extra love and attention, building a relationship with a difficult child, listening to hard truths, persevering in prayer, fighting temptation, apologizing, forgiving, showing yourself compassion and grace, feeling your feelings, breaking a destructive cycle, biting your tongue, controlling your temper, saying goodbye to your parents, saying goodbye to your child leaving home, taking a baby step only God can see. When I was a young girl, I couldn't understand why my mom cried over laundry or because she felt tired. I thought her life purpose was to serve me, and I cringe when I think about all the times that I acted ungrateful, shrugged her off.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.